Hey there, Roland Archer here with CPJHL Hockey. We're here with TJ Renhart with the Seaforth Generals, the general manager and head coach. Now, TJ, all roads lead to tonight. It's basically your home opener here in Seaforth. Are you ready?
Yeah, we're ready. Boys are battle ready. We're working on it for the last 3 weeks now. We've got a good lineup tonight. We're playing four full lines of forwards, 5D, and Spencer Redmond's getting the start tonight in net for us, so it's going to be a good thing. The boys have been leading up to this now for 3 weeks of solid practices and off-ice training, and it's time to show this that we're ready to go and get this going tonight against Grey Highland.
Now, each team, Grey Highland, that you're facing tonight, is there special prep for each team that you face, or is it basically be ready for anyone?
Yeah, as the season goes on and then we see teams once or twice, there's more and more preparation, obviously. Like tonight, they put a roster out. They've got, they're dressed in 12 skaters and 2 goalies, so they've got a smaller lineup tonight. They're missing some guys, but this is our first time seeing them this year, so we got to kind of feel them out in the first 10 or 15 minutes of the game and go from there and maybe change their plan of attack for the second or third periods.
Now, you told me they were running a little late on the bench. Do you let go on, let up on the gas, or do you basically let's show everybody what we can do?
No, I've never been a guy that's willing to let up on the gas because they're short numbers. Usually bites you in the butt, for sure. Teams win all the time with 12 or 13 guys. We did it last year to ESSA twice, and Grey Highland come here one night with 10 guys and did it to us. So we can never let up, never let easy. You got to go all out all the time in this league.
Now, finally, let's talk about the league in general. What are you hoping that people get from seeing the action here tonight, watching CPJHL hockey?
I hope everybody's happy with tonight's game. A lot of local kids in the lineup that are excited to prove themselves that they can play at this level. There's a lot of junior C teams and junior B teams that passed on some of these guys, so some of them have a vendetta out to show people that they're meant to play at this level, and I know they can. Our last week, our exhibition game against Coldwater was a 7-1 game, but take away 8 minutes and 5 goals in the second period, that's a 2-1 game, and we controlled the play for the first and third periods. It was our destiny, and we let it slip out of our hands, and we corrected that. Goalie from last weekend, Mitch Vollmer, has gone elsewhere to play hockey. Spencer Edmond, who was a great 16-year-old for us last year, is back in the lineup tonight, and he's getting the start, so he proved it. The guys are ready to go in front of him, and it's going to be a good game.
Thanks, TJ. Everybody, we're going to go check out with the other coach right now, but get ready for some CPJHL hockey.
Hello, and welcome to the home opener of the Seaforth Generals. Tonight, the Generals welcome the Grey Highland Hawks. They're our second home opener in team history. Tonight, the Generals have a special guest with us, Brock Chessel. On August 22nd, Brock underwent a liver transplant, and less than 5 weeks later, after a successful transplant, Brock was back on the ice, practicing with his minor Pee Wee AAA Lakers teammates. B-Rock, as he is known in the Facebook world nowadays, and the entire Chester family have faced his battle with cancer head-on, with perseverance, determination, dedication, and a can't lose mentality. This is something that we at the Seaforth Generals have adopted and admired in them. So tonight we are collecting funds for the Children's Cancer Foundation of Canada in honor of Rob Chessel, as well as Rebecca Price Kimfer. Rebecca is the youngest sister of Generals defenseman Anthony Kimfer. On Saturday, Rebecca tragically lost her battle to cancer. If we could just have a moment of silence in her honor. We have a representative of the Grey Highland Hawks down to the face-off lot, and Seaforth Generals Captain Brendan Pruitt.
Hey there, Roland Archer here with the head coach and the head of hockey operations, Matt Miscavige, with the Grey Highland Hawks. Is that right? There we go. Now, I hear you have a little bit of a short bench. I mean, how do you adjust your game plan to make up for that?
The big thing we're going to do tonight is we're just going to roll everybody. Everyone's going to get their first shift in, see how it goes. We've got a little bit of a short bench tonight, but it doesn't worry me at all. I know these guys can come and get it at a high level. We can take care of business.
Now, in terms of each competitor, have you known anything about the Seaforth Generals before you came in tonight?
A little bit. I watched a little bit of the game in the preseason against Coldwater, so I've seen a little bit, but it's a new league for me this year, so everyone's a new team. Everyone has a new season. New players come in, new players come out, so it's about in-game adjustments from here on.
Now, in terms of evolving the team, is anyone coming in the next future games to kind of fill up the bench?
Yes, we actually do. I have an Australian World Junior kid who will be coming to join us here in the next few weeks, and we have a couple of Europeans on the higher level of junior teams over there that are still waiting to get their final call back. So, like I said, I have some more guys coming in here, and we're just getting ready for this game tonight, and that's what our main focus is.
Thanks, Matt. Good luck tonight.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
No problem. Okay, everybody, here's some CPJHL action.
Thank you. guys.
I'm kind of passionate.
Yeah. Visitor's penalty number 98. 5 minutes of fighting against Estrada. Home penalty number 21. 5 minutes of fighting in third against Estrada.
Yeah. Thank you.
Top school scored by number 45, Dayton Sports. Assist number 11, Tyler Lovitz. Assist number 96, Adam Gilbert.
Thank you. Thank you.
goal, scored by number 96, Dan Burrow, assisted by number 31, Valeri Lizetsky, and number 5, Angus McKinnon. Is the winner of either a fridge or a jersey. Also, Pauline Schwartz is getting the prize that he hasn't taken. Chocolate Basket was won by Sharon Gaffney. Thank you. 16, assist number 4 and number 8.
Come on. Thank you. Good game. 1-1.